Hello, everybody. Welcome to today's stream of RedHawk Radio. I am your commentator for today's baseball game versus the Butler Bulldogs from Indiana. It seems I am on my own today, despite it being my first broadcast, so if you could cut me some slack, I'm really trying my best. And I'm very sorry about the squeaking sound. That's just the covering I'm under, and it's quite windy today. Anyway, seems like a good matchup for today. We got a win in our last game, and hopefully we can, you know, start another winning streak after losing straight in the game before our last one. Currently, Miami in the MAC standings is 4th from the bottom. We have a 2-4 conference record. We're 7-10 overall. Kind of a poor season. Could be better, but, you know, we're hoping to do our best and, you know, maybe get another win on the board. Hopefully go to 8-10. Okay. Butler seems like a pretty good team. They have a few batters above 300, have about four. They have one guy with a 434 batting average. That'd be Carter Dolray. Anyways, that's enough of that. The lineup for today, starting with Butler, spot number one would be number 24, Bosch from Butler, catcher. Second in the lineup is number 11, McDonald, center fielder. Number 3 for Butler is number 15, Zabariski. He's the third baseman. Number 4 in the lineup is number 31, the first baseman, R. Novak. Fifth in their lineup is the shortstop, number 6, Baker. Sixth in the lineup will be the left fielder, Zarlingo, wearing number 2. Seventh in their lineup is a designated hitter, Gorski, number 8. Eighth person in the lineup is number 23, Barrel. He's a right fielder. The ninth person in Butler's lineup is number 4, Gordon, the second baseman. And the 10th person in their lineup is DeMonica. He's a pitcher, wearing number 19. Give me one second here. Miami, lineup card. First in the lineup is our shortstop, Dolray. I am apologizing again. It's my first day. I just read actually the RedHawks lineup. Okay, now we'll go to the Butler lineup. Number 1 is Dolray, shortstop. Number 2 in their lineup is Urban, center fielder. Number 3 in the lineup is Mononok, left fielder. Number 4 in the lineup is the designated hitter, Drum, number 31. Fifth in the lineup is Lewis, the first baseman, number 6. Sixth in the lineup is Woods, the third baseman, number 7. Seventh in the lineup is the right fielder, Carter, wearing number 13. Eighth in the lineup is the catcher, Vada, wearing number 35. And ninth in the lineup is Choi, the second baseman, wearing number 8. So far this year, the stat we just for Miami, our best hitter would be Zach McDonald. He has a 410 batting average, 1.27 OPS. He's all, also our home run leader with 4 home runs on the season, and he has 15 RBIs. Another Red Hawk to look out for is Rylan Zabariski, batting 328 with a .969 OPS. He is the second home run leader. He has 3 on the year, and he also has 15 RBIs. Another Red Hawk to look out for, the RBI maestro with 18 RBIs, is Ty Baltich. He's batting .288, but he seems to get them runs in when it counts. Anyways, just in a moment here, we'll be hearing the national anthem, and after that, we'll be back. National anthem is just played, and now the Red Hawks are running out onto the field to the start of the first inning. They're now being announced by the stadium announcer. I'd say it looks like a pretty exciting game. Yeah, it is a pretty nice day, kind of chilly, kind of windy, but it's a very sunny one. Barely any clouds in the sky, I will say. Very, very clear skies for a chilly day, so thankfully I don't think it looks like we're getting any precipitation of any kind. Let's see. I don't know if I'm making any mistakes. Get on the mound. I'm very sorry.
Red Hawks over 19 is Nick DeMonico.
Yeah. Again, might have heard the announcer. I might have overheard him. Pitching for the Red Hawks, he's warming up right now, is Nick DeMonica. A pitcher with an 8.31 ERA. His whip is 2.19. He's yet to get a win this season. He's 0-1. This will be his second appearance. His second game. Seems that this will actually be Nick's first game started. Pitching wise, for those of you who are unfamiliar, 8.31 is not the best ERA in the world, but you know, I have faith that you know Nick can pull it out for us and you know pull off some two plays. Now, first at the plate for Butler is Do-Right, the shortstop. DeMarco pitches. Is a strike. He throws the pitch. Strike two. A foul ball outside to the left. That's how you do right is struggling at the plate. Another pitch. It is foul. Takes. Getting his motion, he throws the pitch. A hit to right infield. He is out of here. Do right. The RedHawks now have given them one out.
Center fielder, number 12, Joey Irvin.
Joey Irvin, the center fielder from Butler, is coming up to the plate. He's swinging on the left side of the box. DeMarco throws a pitch. It is going to the left outfield in a ground ball. He makes it the first. He's trying for second. Can the RedHawks get it? And he is safe at second base. The shortstop had whiffed on the throw, but I will say that batter was quite speedy, so it would have been tough to get him anyway. As Irvin, the center fielder, he is now on second. He's talking to the first base coach.
The left fielder, number 16, Jack Moroknik.
Jack Moroknik is now at the plate, hitting in the right side of the box. DeMarco is getting ready in his pitching motion. With a strike. That's one strike down. 1-0 in the count. Irvin seems to be leading off. He might be looking to steal third. Monaco has hit the pitcher, Rocknick. He has now walked him to first.
I'm
guessing that would be a situation of, you know, whittle control. I'm not familiar with the history of those two players. I doubt he hit him on purpose. Yeah, now at the plate is number 31, Drum, the designated hitter for the Butler Bulldogs. He takes a swing and a miss at DeMarco's first pitch to him. Strike one. Drum is getting ready in the batter's box. DeMarco sees Irvin trying to steal, but catcher. With the ball, but he got it back to DeMarco. Still a runner on first, second, and random draw. I'm looking to advance, hit the Butler players on the bases. Monaco throws a ball. Monaco gets ready to throw. Another pitch. High ball. That was just high, left of the box. Monaco needs to really get his control down to pick off and get these batters out of here. And he walked him. The bases for Butler are now loaded. Coming up to the plate is the first baseman, Lewis, from...
First baseman, number six, Cade Lewis.
Yes, Cade Lewis from Butler is now at the plate with the bases loaded. First inning. It's not looking good for the RedHawks, but I know that if we rally on them, they can do it. Monaco throws the first pitch. It is high. Count is 0-1. He throws the second pitch. Strike one. Count is 1-1. Again, the bases are loaded. Monaco throws the pitch. Strike two. Come on, DeMonaco. One more to go. And that'd be the second out. They still need to get another one out. DeMonaco throws a ball low, but he swings at it, and he, Lewis, is struck out. So beginning of the inning, RedHawks have given, have gotten two Butler players out. But this bases are still loaded. Coming up now to the plate is number seven, Woods from Butler. Monaco throws a ball top left, just outside of the box. That'll be a ball. He gets ready for his second pitch to the batter. He throws it low. Ball two. And bases are still loaded. No one looks too antsy off of their bases. Oh, he goes for the pickoff. Did he get it? Person at second base, DeMonaco, saw him trying to lead off. But DeMonaco is too vigilant. First, all the basemen are leading off a bit. He throws the pitch. That is ball three for DeMonaco. DeMonaco throws another pitch. It is wild. On that straight? Okay. Number seven gets ready to bat. And Monaco has gotten the second strike he needs. Monaco needs to get this batter out, or there'll be surely someone trying to get a run. He just walked a batter. He actually walked the player, number one in the lineup, do right all the way around. That was Urban.
Number 13.
Bases are, again, they are still loaded. Number 13 for Butler is now coming up to the plate. Xavier Carter. He is a 237 hitter, right fielder. not to be messed with. It seems that Butler has a lot of heady hitters on this team, so the Redhawks are not messing around. The manager for the Redhawks is actually doing a mound visit right now. Seems to be checking on DeMonica. Now Miami's manager is now walking back to the dugout, and the catcher walking back to his box. Again, for those who might have missed it, the bases are currently loaded with Xavier Carter, number 13 for Butler, at the plate. The first inning. Monica is getting in his pitching motion. He throws the pitch. Wide outside, but Xavier Carter swung on it. That'll be strike one. Monica prepares. Throws second pitch to Carter. Throws the pitch. It is grounded out to right field. Butler has one runner in. They get a second, and they get two players on bases, one at first and one at second. Wow. Seems it is now 3-0
for the Redhawks.
Now up for Butler batting is number 35, Cade Vada, the catcher. Hopefully the Redhawks can get their third out here. It is looking rough. We are already down 3-0. He throws the ball, and it is a strike. Marco throws the pitch. It is long. Ball. Marco sees the baseman leading off. He is being vigilant and seeing if he has a chance at a pickoff. Now DeMonico getting ready to pitch again to Cade Vada. DeMonico throws the pitch and hits Cade Vada, walking him to first base. The bases for Butler are loaded again. Now, I am a big Redhawks fan, and I will say things are not going good. They are not looking bright for the Redhawks. In the first inning, we are down 3-0 already. We need one more out. Hopefully, we can rally together, get another out, and maybe put some points on the board for the Redhawks. DeMonico throws the pitch. It does not swing it. That will be a ball one. Again, the bases are loaded. DeMonico is being vigilant to see if he has a pickoff. Butler's hitter hits it deep into left field. It is out of here. That's a home run grand slam. Oh my goodness, the Redhawks. This is a deep deficit that we've gotten ourselves into in only the first inning. With one hit, they have cleared the bases. Now, up the bat is number 4, Carter DeRay. I was calling him DeRay. This seems to be their best hitter on the team by batting average. Monica throws down the center. Ball. Monaco throws another pitch down the center. His first strike. Hopefully two more can follow. DeMonaco preparing. He throws the pitch. And that is fouled high to the left. Counts now 2-2. DeMonaco throws another pitch. It is again fouled high left. Count is still 2-2. Dude, I'm fouling twice. DeMonaco throws another ball. And it fouls to the left. Count is 2-2. DeMonaco has thrown another ball down the middle. It was just too high in the box. The count is 3-2. Michael looking to get the third out to end the inning for Butler. He grounds it to the left. He is running to first. He is running to second. That is a double by Carter Duray. It seems the RedHawks cannot catch a break. Next in the batting order for Butler, up at the plate is number 12, Joey Urban. The center fielder. DeMonaco is really looking to get this third out. Hopefully he can do it with Joey Urban. DeMonaco gets in his form with Duray. Leading off on second. DeMonaco gets a strike with the first pitch to Joey Urban. DeMonaco throws his second pitch. It is a ball. And two outs. Score is 7-0. DeMonaco throws the ball. It is fouled up into the right. The count is now 1-2. Number 4 for Butler is still leading off pretty far on second base. Potential pickoff situation. DeMonaco throws it way to the right, almost hitting Joey Urban with the ball. The count is now 2-2. Man at second leading off. DeMonaco has now struck out the third batter. Starting the inning for the Miami offense.
Baseballs immediately leave the field at great speeds. Please follow the ball and stay alert at all times. Also,
I'll tell you as
leaning on
we're going
the protective nets around the field. Thank you.
Into the RedHawks offense. I'll tell you, I'm getting worried here. We are down 7. And it is only the first inning. This could be a major blowout. But hopefully the RedHawks can get some points on the board. Butler's pitcher. Gage Mata is warming up at the moment. He is a right-handed pitcher. This number 39, Gage Mata, he has a 21.94 ERA. Three strikeouts. Only three strikeouts on the season. tell you, that is quite the stats. He has almost doubled the ERA of Miami's pitcher, DeMonico. Now, coming up first in the batting order for Miami's RedHawks is Ty Bautasich. He is currently batting 306. Excuse me, sorry. He has a 419 slugging percentage, a 389 on base percentage.
Number 24, Ty Bautasich.
Hopefully, Ty can get a hit and give a good early start for the RedHawks offense and hitting. First pitch from Gage Vada, and it is a strike. He throws the second pitch to Ty. The count is 1-1. Ball. The third pitch, a ball from Gage Vada. Ty had the resilience to not swing at that. It did look pretty close to the box, but you know, it takes real patience in a batter. And that shows greatness when you're able to have patience. Speaking of impatience, Ty just swung in the ball that was just, like it seemed, outside the box or just on the verge. The count is now 2-2, as it was a strike. Gage throws another pitch. He grounds to center right field. He's running, and he will stay at the first base. Ty Bautasich, number 24, just hit a single.
Number 11, Zach McDonald.
Next up in the Miami order is number 11, Zach McDonald, the player with the best batting average on the team. He has a 764% slugging percentage and is batting 455. The first pitch. By Gage, and it is a ball. The count is 1-0. Gage knows he has to be careful with someone like Zach because he is a hitter. Second pitch, and it is deep into right field, right by the foul line, but in the fairway. Zach advances to second base, and Ty advances to third base. What a hit from Zach McDonald, getting a double for the RedHawks. Hopefully this momentum can continue, and the RedHawks take advantage and get closer to tying this game up and getting a more competitive showing.
Third baseman, number 15.
Now up in the batting order is number 15. Third baseman, Rylan Zabrowski, batting 296. First pitch, it is a ball. Count 1-0. And we have a runner on second and third. Second pitch, another ball. Count 2-0. I'll tell you. Again, being a baseball player takes good patience and not swinging at pitches. They're just outside the box. Speaking of swinging, Rylan swung at a pitch that seemed like it was just inside the box by a hair and got a strike. The count is now 2-1. Gage throws another pitch. The count is now 3-1. Ball. I'm pulling for Zabrowski to hit it big and hopefully advance a runner to home. Zabrowski gets ready in his batting stance. Vada throws the pitch, and it fouls high to the right. The count is now, or the count is still 3-2. Zabreski's now in his batting form. Vada throws his pitch, and it is way outside to the left. He has walked Zabreski to first. The bases are now loaded for the RedHawks. Hopefully, the next man in the lineup, number 31, Ryan Novak, can take advantage. I will say, Ryan seems to be the second best hitter by average in the lineup today, batting .349. His slugging percentage is .581, on base percentage .525. The first pitch from Vada to Novak, and it is a strike. The count is 0-1. The second pitch, it fouls off just right behind the catcher. Thankfully, the catcher did not get his hands on that one, as it went right above his head. The count is 0-2. No outs on the board yet, and bases loaded. The third pitch, it is a grounder to center field. And the attempted double play by Butler, they got Ryland Zabrowski out at second. We now have a runner at first and third.
The shortstop, number six.
Now up is the shortstop, number six, Dylan Baker, batting .302 for the RedHawks this season. With the runner on first and third, first pitch gets thrown out by Vada. The pitch is way outside of the box, a very obvious ball right there. The RedHawks have one out. Two men on base, one man on first, one man on third. Hopefully, Dylan Baker can. Oh, he tries to pick off Novak at first base, but he is too slow. Vada does not get him. Novak is safe. Vada still looking at the runners on the bases. See if he can get a cheeky pickoff. Vada getting ready. He pitches. That is way high above the box, almost above his catcher's head. That's ball two, count 2-0. Can the RedHawks have one out? Hopefully, Dylan Baker can hit it big. That is strike one on the third pitch for Vada. Baker has one strike. Two balls. It seems a lot of wild pitches coming from Vada today. Maybe we'll see more walks. I spoke too soon. Vada just got strike two. Count is now 2-2. Hopefully Baker can get a single or a double out of this and help dig the RedHawks out of the hole. Dylan popped up the ball to center field, and it is caught by the outfielder. Center outfielder has caught the ball, and that is the second out for the RedHawks with base runners. All right, number two, Anthony Zarlingo, the left fielder, batting .267 batting average. Vada throws his pitch. That is ball one. RedHawks have two outs. Also, McDonald had gotten picked off on the previous play. Zerlingo is tied in the count. It's 1-1. One ball, one strike. Again, two outs for the RedHawks. They really need to pull their weight. A grounder to right field. And He is out. He is not fast enough to get to the first base. It was very close, but it was clear that he was out. We are now into the second inning.
Fans, any home run hit over the left field wall during today's game.
The score update is 7-2. Butler winning. Now, I'll tell you, the RedHawks are down over 5 scores. It will be tough to come back, but hopefully the dream can be made. DeMonica is now on the mound, warming up, getting ready to hopefully pitch better. Number 14 for Miami is actually pitching now. They have taken DeMonica out probably after the 7 runs he allowed in the first inning alone. Now pitching is Patrick Mastrain, the fourth. He has an ERA of 8.87. He's not on my sheet. Let me look for another stat. Oh, sorry. Patrick has. Oh, it seems that the statistics on the Miami website are different. I'll go off the sheet. He has a 1.6 whip. His win-loss record is 1-1 as a pitcher. He has 6 appearances and 5 games started. It seems that Miami has put no offense to Nick DeMonica. I'm sure he's trying his best, but that type of pitching is just going to dig Miami into a hole. And I felt the change in pitcher and switch was needed.
Leading off for Butler.
And everyone has rough days, but seven runs in one inning is that's just a rough start for a pitcher. Anyway, first up for Butler is Jack Marokinik with the Mastrain with the pitch. Is a strike. Strike one. Count is 0-1. Marokinik getting in his batting stance. Mastrain throws the second pitch, and it pops up into the left. The left outfielder has the ball, now throwing it to the shortstop, and he stops at first base. A single for Marokinik. Now up to the plate for Butler is number 31, Ryan Drum. He is a 250 batting average player. Hopefully Mastrain can get him out. Oh boy. Mastrain throws the pitch. And it is low, but he had swung on it. Drum swung on a pitch that was almost touching the dirt right as it passed the line in the plate. Strike one. The second pitch is wild and out to the left by Mastrain. That'll be ball one. Count 1-1. Again, Butler has a man on first. Hoping to. And he tries to pick off the man at first, Marokinik, but he is too fast and we are not able to pick him off. He dives into the base to avoid being caught. Mastrain getting ready to throw another pitch. He throws a fastball right down the middle. Strike two. Count is now 1-2. Hopefully we can get an out right here. Mastrain throws another pitch. It is outside, but he had swung on it. That is strike three, the first out for Butler. Now coming up to the plate is number six, Cade Lewis, the first baseman. He is batting 356 on the season. Hopefully we can change that and get that number a bit lower with Patrick Mastrain. Patrick Mastrain throws the first pitch, a fastball right down the middle. What a heater. Strike one. Getting one out for Butler at the moment. They have a man at first. Cade Lewis getting in his batting stance. Mastrain throws another pitch. It is popped foul. The count is 0-2. One more strike and we'll get that second out we are looking for desperately to try and become competitive in this game. Another pitch is not swung at, but it was outside and to the right of the box. The count is now 1-2. Mastrain getting ready for another pitch. It is hit up in straight into the center, and it is caught. Thrown to first, and that is two outs. The inning for Butler is over, and now the Miami RedHawks will take the field to bat. I'll say nothing against. Sorry. Nothing against DeMonica, but Mastrain just really showcased his talent out there. And I mean, maybe Butler just got very lucky in that first inning, but Mastrain showing a very different story for the RedHawks in the second inning, keeping them scoreless, not even a man advancing to third in that inning for Butler. Now warming up for up that pitcher for the I'm very sorry about the wind and squeaking. It was just very, very windy here today, and I'm under intent to actually block some of that. Okay, again, pitching is Gage Vada. Again, according to my stat sheet in front of me, a 21.94 ERA. Now, first batting is Justin Gorski for Miami, number 8, the designated hitter, batting 222 on the season. Hopefully, we can start out hot and get some steam in this game. A grounder to right field, and that is a easy single for Justin Gorski. A good, small, but solid start to the second inning for the Miami batters. Now up is Garrison Barrill, number 23, the right fielder, batting 235 on the season. Again, we have a man at first, no outs. He tries to pick off Gorski, but Gorski is too fast. He cannot get it there in time. Gorski was safe. Or is he leaning off a bit, maybe looking to steal? And Duada throws another pitch right, or throws his first pitch right down the center. Ball. Count is 1-0. And hopefully we can get off to a good start here. We have zero outs and a man on first base. Small, but it can be a big start to something. A ball hit up and directly into the sky, straight into the hands of the center outfielder. A tough break for Garrison Barrill. Now up, up to a Tupac song, it is Tyler Gordon, number 4, the second baseman. According to statistics, he is the batter with the worst average in the lineup today, batting 175 for the season. Gordon hits it foul on the first pitch. Count is 0-1. Again, the RedHawks have one out, a man at first. Again, one out is really nothing. We can just be getting started, or this could be the beginning of the end of the inning for the RedHawks. Again, trying to pick off the man at first base, Justin Gorski, but the pitcher, Gage Vada, is too slow. Tyler Gordon hits it up into the sky, and it drops a deep ball to the left field end. It seems all of the outfielders for Butler got confused on who was going through for the ball. They ran into each other and ended up letting the ball just drop. Miami now has a man at first and second. Two bases. Now up is number 24, Ty Botters. Twitch. Again, he's batting 317 on the season. Hopefully he can get the runners moving. Gage throws the first pitch. It is a ball. Count is 1-0. Well, only one out for the RedHawks. Two men on base, first and second. Let's see what Ty Botich can do. The second pitch is called a strike. That seemed like a two-seam fastball. About to get ready to throw his third pitch. He throws a fastball right in down the middle, low in the box. Watch Bowditch hit up into the sky, which was then caught by the outfielder. Two outs for the RedHawks now, but a man on first and a man on second. Now coming up is number 11, Zach McDonald, the center fielder. The man with the best batting average in the current lineup.
Zach McDonald.
And he is batting an insane 464 on the season. What a hitter. He's getting ready in his batting stance. Bada throws the first pitch, but it is far to the left outside of the box. His catcher had to stretch for that one. The count is 1-0. Again, two outs for the RedHawks, a man at first, a man at third. He throws another pitch. Seems like a changeup. That was ruled a strike as it was low and out of the box, but it was swung on by McDonald. McDonald getting ready for the third pitch. He tries to pick off a man at first again, but he is too slow. This pitcher might be paranoid because he wasn't even leading off the base that far. And he just keeps on throwing, trying to pick them off and catch them lacking. Catch them looking silly. But the Miami RedHawks are not silly. Cap McDonald looking to take another pitch. He hits it high into the sky in center field. Is that far enough? And that is out of here. A home run for Zach McDonald. For Zach McDonald, that is his fifth home run of the season, if I am correct. As I do not think. Yes, that is, according to my statue, his fifth home run of the season. He just cleared the bases. The score is now 7-5. Butler still winning. Now up is another batter. He pops it up into the air. That is, I'm very sorry about this persistent squeaking. It's just the fault of the crazy wind out here, being in a hurricane. Zabrowski was the batter that popped it up in the air and got out immediately. Again, You know, can't be too mad at him. We just saw Zach McDonald hit an absolute monster home run. With the angle of the ball that it was launched at, it did not look like it was going to get up there. But, I mean, I think the wind is going in the direction of the outfield wall. Maybe the wind caught it and, you know, was able to help get it that extra distance. But, again, it still looked about 10, 15 feet past the wall. But, you know, as it popped up, it looked like it might have barely cleared the fence. But I was proven wrong.
Miami
doing something interesting here. In the start of the third inning, they have now switched the pitcher again to Peyton Olenek. He has a 7.80 ERA. Seems to be a decent pitcher. He is throwing pretty fast in his warm-up pitches to his catcher. Again, Miami is 2-4 in the conference. The thing is, this is not a conference game, but our overall record in baseball currently is 7-10. Yikes. Hopefully, we can get win today and come back from this deficit and make that 8-10.
Leading off for Butler, number 7, Billy Wirch.
Now batting for Butler University is number 7, Billy Wirch, the third baseman, batting average of .250. I'm curious to see how number 33, Peyton Olenek, the pitcher for the RedHawks, does. First pitch, and it is a strike. Should be for the RedHawks, so I probably shouldn't this, but yeah, I'm really not sure if that was a strike, and he didn't swing on it. And it looked quite outside the box, but yeah, I'll take it. Go RedHawks. The second pitch, ball, count is 1-1. Peyton Olenek looking to get another strike. Sorry for the wind. I will turn down my mic a little bit to try and mediate and diminish the wind noise. Peyton Olenek throws his third pitch, ball. The count is now 2-1. Seems that in college, most of these pitches are just straight fastballs. A fastball now thrown by Peyton Olenek again. Ball 3. Count is 3-1. He needs a watch or he will walk Wirch to first base. Pinoyer throws another pitch. Strike 2. Hopefully we can get that third strike on this next pitch. Full count. Count 3-2. And he walks Billy Wirch to first. Pinoyer looking frustrated.
Number 13.
But he is shaking it off. Now up to bat for Butler is number 13, Xavier Carter, a .250 batting average hitter, right fielder on defense. Peyton is getting in his pitching form. Peyton throws a four-seam fastball down the middle and gets a strike. Count is 0-1. Another heater down what looked like the middle, but could have been where I was just sitting at, but that was called a ball to me that looked right in the box. So y'all might need glasses. Anyways. He tries to pick off the runner at first, but Peyton does not get him in time. Billy Wirch leading off a bit from that first base as the hitter Xavier Carter looks to be in his batting stance. Peyton throws another heater down the middle And Carter is just too slow to swing at it. Count is now 1-2. Two strikes. One more. And that'll be an out for Butler. Another in the middle. That looks to be almost going in my head. He fouled it up and back towards the parking lot and engineering buildings. That foul ball went so far, I wouldn't be surprised if someone saw that in the Benton Window Lounge. I don't know if that's officially what it's called, but kind of what I consider the area. Anyway, Peyton pitches again, but it is low. The count is now 2-2. Peyton throws another pitch. It is hit high into the air, but the outfielder catches it and gets the first out for the Red Hawks. Now up to bat is number 35, Cade Vada, the catcher. Now, I could be mistaken, but I just now realized that Cade and Gage Vada are different players. One is a pitcher, one is a hitter. I guess they are most likely related in some way or just have the same last name. The first pitch thrown by Peyton, and it is just a bit outside. It is called a ball. Count is 1-0. Butler still has a runner at first, number 7, Billy Wirtz. But he can't seem to get in stealing position. He's staying right on that base. He doesn't even seem to be leading off one bit. Cade Vada getting in his batting stance. Peyton getting ready to pitch. He throws a sinker right down the middle. But it goes too low. Ball two. Count is 2-1. One out for Butler's anything at the moment. Another four-seam fastball right down the middle in a second strike. The count is now 2-2. Peyton Olenek hoping to capitalize. Not really to Kenny Olenek as far as I know. Oh, wow. A foul ball hit by Cade Vada. Well, he's still in this. That one looked like he was flying right at the commentary booth. My wife flashed before my eyes, but thankfully there's that big glorious net in front of us. Anyway, Peyton Olenek is now getting ready to throw his next pitch. He gets in his stance, throws it, and it grounds to the right. The second baseman just tries to slide and get it, but he is not fast enough. Billy Wirtz advanced to third base, and Cade Vada advanced to first. There are two men on base, one on first, one on third for Butler. Now up in batting order is Ian Choi. He is quite the hitter with a .345 batting average. Now again, there is a potential that these are inflated stats because who knows, he might have not played a lot of games and just did very well, but that's just stats I'm working with. But so far, he is 1-1 today. Olenek throws a pitch right fast down the middle. Ian Choi didn't even get a chance to react. Before he knew it, there was a strike in that count. 0-1. Another fastball, but it is just outside the box to the right. Again, that is a very close call to make. That could go either way for the ump. Another fastball, but there is the speed, but it is just, again, outside of the box. This one a bit higher than the last one, but still out on the right side of the box. Count is now 2-1 with one out. A man on first and a man on third for Butler. Ian Choi does not swing as Olenek throws a ball far left, very low and outside the box, clearly. It doesn't take a genius to not swing at that, though. But me on MLB The Show, I probably would have. Oh, hey, runner, he's trying to steal home, and he is safe. That is Billy Wirtz with a score. The catcher just missed the ball, and Billy Wirtz took the opportunity to capitalize. There's now a runner, Ian Choi, on first, and Cade Vada on second. Now is a mound visit from Miami's manager. I'll tell you, this has been a tough game for the RedHawks, but they have shown signs of still being in it and wanting to come back. I tell you, being down 7-0 in the first inning must have been very demoralizing for the RedHawks, but you know, they didn't let it get them down, and, you know, they're still trying to push for that next win of the season, which would bring their record to 8-10. So looking for that 8th win, they are not giving up. All right. Now, it seems there was a switch up with the pitcher being used by Miami. Is that correct? Where is my stats? Now pitching for Miami and warming up currently is number 27, Luke Ross. This man has a 6.75 ERA, 10 strikeouts. Stat sheet I have, Luke Ross is currently having a 5.63 ERA with a 1.88 whip. This would be like one of the pitchers with the lowest ERA on the Miami roster statistically this season. Now batting for Butler is Carter Durai, number 4, the shortstop, with a man on first and second for Butler. There is only one out. But that first pitch from Luke Ross was a strike to the great hitter in Carter Durai. He looks at the baseman and throws another pitch, but just outside the box in the bottom right corner. Seems that right side of the box is just like a hair away from most of these Miami pitchers. It is quite an interesting approach, I will say, for a different pitcher every inning, but maybe that's something about college baseball I haven't realized yet. Again, being a fairly new commentator, I'm less familiar with college baseball. I mainly watch MLB. So maybe this is something normal. But with experience, I'll be able to give you more accurate commentary and feedback. The next pitch from Luke Ross. And it bounces off of the catcher's glove. The runner at first steals second. And the runner at second steals third. There's now a man at third and a man at second. Seems that the pitcher is taking some time to talk with his catcher. The catcher in the past just inning has made few errors, which are costly. I'm not sure if it was the pitch to blame or the catcher, but oh wow. some costly plays for the RedHawks. Again, scores 8-5, one out for Butler. And the count is 3-1, three balls, one strike. Hopefully we can get that second strike right now. And he walks the batter. There are now loaded bases for this Butler team with only one out. A scary sight for any pitcher, part of the Miami RedHawks. Hopefully Luke Ross has the dexterity to close this inning out and prevent any scoring from the loaded bases situation he's found himself in. Now up to bat is number 12, Joey Irvin for Butler. Taking his time to pitch again. Lucross throws another ball. The count is 2-0. Again, I'm really not sure. I mean, it's better than a big hit. It's better to walk someone and only give up one run than give up a big hit by playing too safe and inside the box. But in baseball, it's all about risk. It's all about timing. The count is now 3-0. He throws his first strike. Luke Ross looking to strike Joey Irvin out. Again, the bases are loaded. This is a perilous situation for the RedHawks. They are already down three runs, and it is hit deep in the center field and caught by the outfielder. He is trying to steal home, and it seems that the runner that was at third was able to do just that. So sorry. Excuse me. I will mute my mic next time. I'm sorry if I hurt anyone's ears right there. But the score is now 9-5. Butler on top of the RedHawks. But the RedHawks are not out of this yet. It is only the third inning. Now batting for Butler is Jack Moroknik, the left fielder, with a .362 batting averages. Luke throws his first pitch, and wow, was that high. That was nowhere near the strike zone. I thought that one was coming up to the broadcast booth. The count is 1-0. That was a ball. There are runners on first and second. He hits the ball. It foul high into the sky. And Miami's third baseman is able to secure that ball and get the catch off and end that inning for Butler. Now, Butler's players are coming out onto the field and are getting ready for the Miami batters. Again, one thing I know about Miami University is through hardship, when they're pushed down, they always seem to be fighting back. I remember not too long ago, maybe 2 weeks ago, being at the Toledo-Miami basketball game here in Oxford, and we were getting, for lack of word, no better way to describe it, I'd say we were getting pummeled by Toledo by almost 30 points, but you know, I didn't give up hope, and neither did the RedHawks. You know, they didn't get it that close, but you know, they were sure trying as hard as they could. So even in blowout, nice to see that our beloved RedHawks are not going to give up. Coming up to the plate for Miami is number 31, Ryan Novak, the first baseman. He is 0-for-1 today in this game, but hopefully he can get a hit right here off of pitcher Gage Vada. The first pitch is right down center. No swing from Novak. That is strike one. It is hit deep into left field, but it goes foul. The count is now 0-2. More strike, and our player Novak will be out. He fouls again. The count is still 0-2. Bada throws another pitch right down the center, but it is too low. Looked to be a sinker, but he did not place it correctly, and it went below the box into the dirt. Count is 1-2. Another ball for pitcher Gage Vada. Count is 2-2, looking to make a splash with the first hitter, Ryan Novak. Ryan is sadly struck out. That is the first out for Miami in the third inning. Again, score 9-5, Butler on top. Now up for Miami is number 6, Dylan Baker, with a 302 batting average, the shortstop for the Miami RedHawks. First pitch from Vada. It goes just right past the catcher. But he's able to throw back to the pitcher. If there were some RedHawks on base, that would be a really good opportunity to steal, but there's nobody. He hits the batter with the ball. Dylan Baker is walked to first base. Now up is number 2 for the RedHawks, Anthony Zarlingo. He is 0 for 1 so far today, but he is looking to get a hit in this moment. Vada throws the first pitch, and that is strike one. He throws the second pitch, strike two, count 0-2, with one out for the RedHawks. Only one person on base, and he is at first. It is not looking good for our Miami RedHawks. And again, he tries to pick off the runner at first, but he was too slow with the pitch, and he got back and was safe. Dylan Baker was not able to be picked off. That is a far pitch to the right of his catcher. And that is ball one. The count is 1-2. Again, one out for the RedHawks so far in this third inning. The next pitch, an 86 mile per hour heater right down the middle. That is strike three. Two outs for the RedHawks now. Only one man on base, and he is at first. Now, next up for Miami is number 8, Justin Gorski. His last appearance, he had a hit in this game, so hopefully he continues that streak. First pitch, he was looking to bunt on that one. Man. Quite the strategy. That was ball one. Now here is ball two. The count 2-0. And the runner, Dylan Baker, on first. Miami looking to try and get back in this game down 4 runs. The next pitch, a 86 mile per hour fastball right down the center. But it was too low. Ball three. Gorski is very, well, this one did not swing at that, as that looked very close into the box. That one right there was strike one. The count is 3-1. That one was right in the middle. It was prime for the take into the yard, but I guess Gorski did not feel that pitch was at the right time. And the batter, Gorski, is walked to first. Bases now having a runner at first and at second base.
Number 23, Harrison Barrill.
Now up for the Redhawks is number 23, Garrison Barrill. He has not hit in this game yet, but he's looking to start. First pitch is 70 miles per hour. And it is a strike, surprisingly. That was way outside the box, but he still swung. Count is 0-1. One man at first, one man at second. The next pitch, very low on the ground, but he is leaning into it and just barely swung on it. That is strike two. Two outs for the Redhawks. One more strike in this inning. It is over. Hopefully that is not the case. The next pitch, four. It bounces off the ground. The Redhawks have stolen second and third base. One of the factors that might contribute to the wild nature of these pitches today and just the catchers just missing the ball is, you know, there's an intense wind out today. Let me look. Up is number 14. Garrison. Oh, he was still up. Oh, he got walked right there. That was ball four. Bases are now loaded for the Redhawks. Two outs. You got to be careful here, because if you just pop it up or let them, you know, catch a ground ball and just throw the one in base, like, you're out. But, you know, if we get a big home run here, that could be a grand slam. Up is number four, Tyler Gordon, a 195 hitter. But he hit in his last appearance in this game. So we are hopeful for him. Okay, count is 1-0. The second pitch that looked low, and it was not swung on by Tyler, so count is 2-0. Again, two outs so far. And Butler's manager making a mound visit with the catcher for, as far as I know, the first in this game. No, I'll say it is getting colder out here. I can feel my fingers slowly becoming numb, but you know, I am out here and I'm still watching some good, interesting Redhawks baseball. The wind has temporarily calmed at this moment, but speaking of that wind speed, I have just done my due diligence and have now seen that the current wind speed reported by the Weather Service is 19 miles per hour. Now, Howard Gordon takes another pitch, ball three. Count is 3-0, two outs for the Redhawks. Hopefully we can get a run in here, possibly an RBI. That is the first strike for this at-bat for Gage Vada. Count is 3-1 with two outs remaining. Or not two outs remaining, two outs now. Only one more to give up. And he walked the batter. He walked Tyler Gordon all the way to first, and there is a score for the Redhawks in this inning. The score is now 9-6. Redhawks only down three. As I've said, the comeback, it looked unlikely, but it is possible, and it seems like it can occur. Now up is Tyler Baltich, number 24 for the RedHawks. The first pitch, 85 mile per hour fastball down the middle. But again, too low. A lot of the pitches today, just very low from Gage Vada. Another pitch, just pretty far outside the box. That one to the bottom right, almost in the ground. Count is 2-0. Again, two outs for the Redhawks, but bases loaded. Oh, he looked like he was going to bunt right there. That is strike one for this at-bat. Count is 2-1. And the pitch. And it is foul. Count is 2-2. And you can just hear the enclosure of this tent just shaking around me. Metallic tins. Yeah, I'm very sorry. I'll try to turn my mic down a little bit. Another pitch. The count is up 3-2. That was a ball. It is, again, way down in the right bottom of the box. Just, I'd say, about 4 inches outside of the box. This pitch. And looking. And another runner has been walked by Gage Vada. That is another score for the Redhawks. Now 9-7. Butler is still on top, but man, are we getting close. This is way different compared to the fact that we were down by 7 runs at the beginning of the game. The first inning, we were down 7 runs. But now we have cut that lead to 2. Again, I told you, the Redhawks, they are fighters, and they are not giving up. Apparently, just a mound visit from the catcher. But now, next up, coming to the plate, the big hitter himself. He has hit in both his appearances today. Number 11, Zach McDonald. Again, his last appearance, he homered in this game. So, hopefully you can do it again and get a grand slam home run. The first pitch is swung on, but is outside the box, unhittable. That is strike one. Next pitch, a grounder to the side. And that is the end of the inning for the Redhawks. Got him out at second base. And the wind seems to be very much picking up here. All of my stat sheets and notes around in my area, they're all getting all jumbled up and thrown around by this wind, but it's not deterring me from still trying to do the best job for you folks. The Redhawks are now taking the field. Have a pitcher. And now. And pitching. For Miami is again Luke Ross. And being new and all, I'm not sure if this is a college thing, but my gosh, have there been a lot of pitcher change-ups in this game so far for the Redhawks. Seems like the Butler Bulldogs have stuck with the same guy, Gage Vada, the entire game so far, but Miami has about had like 4 pitchers already, and it's only the start of the 4th. Now up at the plate, it is number 31 for Butler, Ryan Drum. The pitch from Luke Ross. And it is just outside. Ball one. Not swung at by the hitter drum. Now, getting into his motion, the second pitch is very far left, 86 miles per hour. Fastball. But it was just, it was not even just outside the box, it was fairly outside the box. Count is 2-0. That is the first strike, a 85 mile per hour heater to the bottom left of the box. Second strike. That was a strike. Ah. Personally, I thought he had swung at it, but whatever the ump sees. Count is 3-1. Three balls, one strike. It is straight popped up into the air. And caught by the outfielder, RedHawks. Caught by number 23. Garrison Barrow. Now up at the plate is number 6, Cade Lewis for the Butler Bulldogs. First pitch by Lou Gross is a ball. Just not inside that box, and Lewis was patient enough to not swing on that. Lou Gross hits a ball foul towards the fence behind home plate. Count is 1-1, one out for Butler. No men on the bases. They are clear. Another pitch. Hit foul by Cade Lewis. Count is 1-2. The next pitch. And it is on the right of the box and not swung on, so the count is now 2-2. That was a ball. Lacrosse gets ready to throw his next pitch. A fastball to the left of the box. Picked up by the right outfielder. But he makes it to first and is not able to get it to the first baseman in time. Butler now has one man on base with number 7, Billy Wirtz, coming up to the plate. First pitch is fouled off on into the right, right towards the Butler dugout. Count is 0-1. Second pitch hits the batter, walks him. Seems to be some commotion concerning him hitting that batter right there.
Number 13.
Not looked personal, looked merely an accident, but there seems to be some noise about it. Anyway. Coming next up to play is number 13, Xavier Carter for Butler. He is 1-2 for his appearances so far. Butler has a man at first and a second in. Pitcher Luke Ross looking to make sure that he can see if there is an opportunity to pick one of them off as they are leaning pretty far from the bases. First pitch was a strike. Count is 0-1. One out for Butler so far. Next pitch is a ball just too far to the right there on that ball. Luke Ross looking at the runners, throws another pitch, 86 mile per hour heater to the bottom left of the box. That's strike two. Count is 1-2. Hopefully Luke Ross can get this out right here. Luke Ross throws it again. It is fouled off of the bat of Xavier Carter. Count is still 1-2. And one out, but hopefully we can get another one here and get closer to shutting out this inning for Butler. And that is a right grounder. Barely missed by the second baseman. And the player, Cade Lewis, is able to run around the bases just fast enough to take a run. Score is now 10-7. And with Cade Lewis running, Billy Wirtz also was able to run to third base. Butler now has a man on first and a man on third. Now up to bat for Butler is number 35, Jay Botta. He is one for one so far in his at plate appearances. Apparently his batting average is .091. All right, first pitch. It is a ball way down to the right. I don't know if it's the windbone or just the way these pitchers are throwing, but it is going in that spot a lot of the time today. LaCrosse getting ready to throw another pitch. It is another ball. Count is 2-0. Getting one out for Butler. They have a man on first, man on third. LaCrosse getting ready for his throwing motion. Ross tries to pick off the runner at first, but is too late. Safe. One of these throws, we're going to get one of them. But, you know, sometimes no runners are picked off in the same game. And the next pitch, thrown a fastball, but too low and outside the box. That is ball three for Luke at this at-bat. Count is 3-0. Another throw. Strike. Strike one. Count is 3-1. Luke Ross throws the next pitch. This man is looking to bunt. But it fouls off. Strike two. Count is now full. Ball three, strike two. Looking for that third one. It fouls off. Count is still and remains 3-2. A man on first, a man on third. Again, Miami does not want to let them regain that very far away lead where it seems unreachable. And the pitcher hits another batter in the same inning. That's two. The dugout seems very displeased with this. Some yelling from the dugout to Miami's pitcher, Luke Ross. And it is pretty windy, but when he got hit, it was a pretty calm breeze. There was no gust at that moment, but who knows. Anyway, the bases are now loaded for Butler. And coming up at the plate is number 8, Ian Choi. Oh, and now Miami's baseball manager is coming again for a mound visit. Maybe they will switch the pitcher for the fifth time in the game. Ryan Smiley is out talking to catcher. And they are, in fact, changing the pitcher. It seems like they are they changing? Yes, they are changing the pitcher. Now pitching for Miami. Number 35, Ryan Zimmer. Zimmer has a 72 ERA. According to the Miami website statistics, but in my up-to-date, it says he still has a 34.71 ERA. For those of you unfamiliar with baseball, a solid or good ERA is usually in the range of 2 to 3 and, you know, sometimes 4. Depends on your fielders. But I'm going to be honest with you. I don't think I've ever seen a stat line read a 34.71 ERA. Again, the potential with stats like this is he might have not played a lot of games and just played in two blowouts. That's why his ERA is so inflated, but still. Wow, estimated runs a lot. Well, hopefully Ryan Zimmer, pitcher number 35 for the Miami RedHawks, will be able to bring us back into this inning, as it seems like our beat of the earlier innings where we, in better or worse words, getting waxed. Wax on, wax off. In other words, we were getting whooped pretty terribly. But hopefully Ryan Zimmer can be a light in the darkness that is currently Miami's situation in game, with loaded bases and down 3 runs, with Ian Choi, a very decent hitter, now at bat for Butler. Ryan Zimmer throwing his first pitch of the game. It is a ball way low and to the left, but 92 mile per hour. What a arm on that man. The next pitch, it is popped straight up into the sky. The shortstop catches it. That is the second out of the inning for Butler. Bases still loaded in this situation. But now coming up to bat is the best hitter statistically on their team is Carter Durie. He's 1-for-2 so far today, but hopefully we can make that 1-for-3 after this at bat. Again, there are two outs. Bases are loaded for Butler. Ryan Zimmer throws a 92 mile per hour fastball right down the center. But it was too far to the left. Oh, okay. Ball one. He throws another one that is not swung at, but it's too high. That's ball two. The count is 2-0. Two outs for Butler, and they have bases loaded with one of their best hitters at bat at this very moment. Ryan Zimmer throws another pitch. That is ball three. 0 strikes on the board. It looks like they might walk in a run, but, you know, I'm going to be hopeful. Hopefully we can strike him out here. Or get him to pop up and just catch it right away. That is strike one. I thought that was a ball right there. I really did. Count is 31, 2 outs for Butler. Bases loaded. Ryan Zimmer throws another heater. 94 miles per hour on that one, but he gets fouled off. Ryan Zimmer, they're trying to steal. And he walks. Walks, do I? Someone from the Miami dugout, presumably the manager, is having some words with the umpire. Umpire's flipping out his little notepad. And he ejected? Miami's manager has been ejected from the game for arguing with the umpire. They're just having a cursing fit with each other. But now he has been ejected from the game. Seems like both men had lost their temper. Wow. His coach was not a fan of the call of that being a ball right there that got them to walk in a free run. Again, now the score, just to update y'all, after that walk is 11-7 with bases still loaded. All the umpires are having a little meeting. They're all huddling up together. But, wow. It seems that tempers have flared up in that moment for Miami coach. Zimmer still warming up his pitch again, but now up for Butler is number 12, Joey Urban. He is 1-for-2 today. This center fielder. Okay, bases loaded. Just to remind everyone, two outs. First ball, very low, but he got it swung at. That is strike one. Zimmer throws the second pitch. It is grounded right to the third baseman, and that is the third out of the inning. Getting Butler out of this. Miami is fighting fierce. They're fighting hard. They might be down by four, but it is only the fourth inning. There is still so much game left to be able to come back and win this thing. I will say, if I was a betting man, I'd bet the over. This game has been very high scoring, and I doubt it to slow down. Both offenses have been very, very hot during this game. And the wind has just made, fielding and pitching the ball very unpredictable at moments. Back as soon as the first Miami batter is in. Has finally changed their pitcher out. Now pitching for Butler is number 43, Christian Finnegan. He's a right-handed pitcher with a 16.2 ERA. And now for Miami, at bat is number 15, Ryland Zarowski. He's looking to get his first hit of the game. For today, the first pitch hit straight up into the sky. Looks like it's about to get caught by the center fielder, and it is. That is the first out for Miami in the fourth inning.
31, Ryan Novak.
Number 31 for Miami, Ryan Novak is now up to bat. first pitch. Strike one. Now for the bottom of the inning, and the RedHawks maybe reduce that deficit. The second pitch, that is ball one. Count is 1-1 tied. Pitch by Christian, and it is another ball. Pretty slow on that pitch, 73 miles per hour. A lot of these guys have been averaging about 80, 90. Okay. The next pitch is right down the middle, but not swung at. That is strike two. Count is 2-2, one out, no one on base for the RedHawks. Novak looks, gets in his batting stance. Finnegan gets in his pitching groove and strikes out Ryan Novak.
Number 6, Dylan Baker.
Now up is number 6 for the RedHawks, Dylan Baker. Hopefully he can brave Christian Finnegan and get a hit off of him. Again, two outs so far in the bottom of the fourth inning for the RedHawks. That pitch not swung on, but very high in the sky. That was a ball. Count is 1-0. And the next pitch, way to the left, not swung on, that is ball three. It's looking like Dylan Baker might get walked, but who knows, anything can happen. The next pitch, right, low, down the center, but that is swung on, a strike. Count is 3-1. Again, two outs for the RedHawks, one out here, and that is the end of the bottom of the fourth. The next pitch, he does not swing, and that is a way high over the head of even the batter. That's such an obvious ball right there. He has been blocked. Now up is number 2, Anthony Zarlingo. He has yet to hit for today's game, but I have faith that maybe he can get it going now in the bottom of the fourth. We have a runner on first. Seems like Dylan Baker is trying to lead off a bit, maybe to potentially steal, but he's got to be careful and not get picked off because one out and we are done with the inning. First pitch was a strike. Count is 0-1. Second pitch. The check swing, but it was way outside, and that is a ball. Count is 1-1. The next and third pitch, and that is strike two. One more strike, and that is the end of the inning for the RedHawks, but, you know, I'm holding out hope. Holding out hope that Zarlingo can get this. Another pitch outside the box, but not swung on. That is ball two. Count is 2-2. Two. I mean, it's jersey number two at the at-bat. Ball two, strike two, out two. Just all across the scoreboard. Might be lucky. And that is a third ball. Count is full. Ball three, strike two. We still have a man at first, being Dylan Baker. He is leading off about 6 feet from the first base. Now the pitch, way out, and he is walked. We have a man on first, a man on second. And now coming up to the plate is number 8, Justin Gorski.
Number 8, Justin Gorski.
I promise I would mute myself by sending off, but that was kind of unplanned. Justin Gorski getting ready in his hitting stance. He bunts the ball, but it is fouled off to the left. Count is 0-1. Next pitch, and it is fouled way up high. Butler's third baseman tries to catch it, and he does, and that's the end of the inning for the RedHawks, sadly. Oh, man. I will say it has been an interesting game with, you know, runs on both sides, but the RedHawks can't seem to shake the chip on their shoulder of being down 3-4 runs almost the entire game. Even in the first inning, being down 7. We'll say it's a tough situation, but we're going to have to tough it out. Still pitching for Miami is Zimmer. 5-1. Now, up at the plate for Butler is number 16, Jack Marechnik. Pitcher is Ryan Zimmer for the RedHawks. First pitch, it is a strike. He slightly swung at something that was most surely a ball, very low into the right. A common theme seen in today's game, in my opinion. Ryan Zimmer throws his second pitch. Strike two. He tried to swing at it, but his timing was off. He was too fast for him. That was a 91 mile per hour fastball right down the center. Ryan Zimmer throws his third pitch. And that is ball one. Slightly to the right. Ryan Zimmer winds up. Throws his fourth pitch. It is popped straight over the air, but foul. Count is 1-2. Two strikes, one ball. Ryan Zimmer winding up. Throws his fifth pitch, but it is way out to the right. Towards the ground. Count is now 2-2. That was a ball. I will say, the longer I stay out here, the colder it gets. Just speaking of the weather. When Zimmer throws another pitch, it is grounded, ready to start. The second baseman, for about the third time just today in this game, tries to dive for it and misses it completely. rough game. Hopefully you can shake that off and just remember to work on that.
Now batting for Butler.
Oh, batting number one is Ethan McGrub. First pitch was a strike right down the center. Next pitch was a ball just to the right of the box. Currently at bat is Ethan Vergrumba, a new addition to the lineup so far for this game. He tries to pick off the runner at first, but he is not fast enough, sadly. Ryan Zimmer, looking down the batter, winds up, throws a pitch. It is popped straight up the third. Oh, wait, the shortstop goes to try and get it. He drops it! The runner is going all the... He just went to second. There are now runners on.
Number 6, Kane Lewis.
Oh, it did not, man. That was foul. There's only a runner on first now. Because I guess he got out tagged. He got greedy for a base. This man, number 6, looking to bunt on the pitch. Number 1 looks to steal. It's very close to tell. Ah, he is safe. Number 1 for Butler. Ethan Vergrumba steals second base. Count is 1-0. One ball, zero strikes. Next pitch. That is strike 1 for that bat. Count is 1-1 currently. Ethan Vergrumba looks at me steal again, but Ryan Zimmer is always watching. He's got eyes on the back of his head. He looked to potentially pick him off, but it was too late. Vergrumba had already gotten back and safe on second base. At the plate, Cade Lewis looks to send him and his teammate further on the bases, but he is struggling. Count is 2-1 at the moment, but it looked like he was about to swing on that last ball. He's swinging, and oh my lord. Vergrum gets right to home, runs all the way from second to home. He has such speed on him, that player from the Butler Bulldogs. I'll say that could have been done like that, but the first baseman didn't catch a ball that was about 3 feet away from him when it started coming towards him and came off of the bat. The trajectory of where I'm very surprised that the first baseman did not get that ball right there. But, you know, now next up is number 7, Billy Wirch for Butler. Butler is now winning 12-7. It's rough. We might go down 7 again. Ryan Zimmer throws, tries to pick off the man at first, but he is not fast enough. The pitch. Ball. Count is 2-0. Only one out for Butler so far. They have one man on base at first. And a man at bat trying to add to that number. Zimmer throws another pitch. That is strike two, 87 mile per hour. Right in the bottom left of the box. He tries to pick off the runner at first again, but again, he is too slow. That runner at first, he has speed like my buddy Max in the hallways of the dorm. I tell you, he doesn't look like it, but he is nimble. Zimmer throws another ball. As Cade Lewis steals second. Oh my. In one inning, we have now had two people on Butler's team, the Bulldogs, steal second. Butler's player, Billy Wirtz, just fouled out on the pitch. Count is currently 2-2 with a man at second after having stolen it. Zero looks back, but that right there is a strikeout. That is now two outs for Butler. Zimmer striking out Billy Wirtz. Now up to bat for Butler is number 13, Xavier Carter. He is 2-for-3 so far in this game, and Zimmerman hopes to make that 2-for-4. The first pitch, a fast strike ball, 92 miles per hour, right in the bottom center of the box. Roger throws another pitch, a ball, count is 1-1. Again, two outs for Butler, a man at second. With Xavier Carter at the plate. He hits it deep. The left fielder gets the ball. And that is the third out. And the end of the top of the fifth inning. I'll tell you. I'm not giving up hope yet. But it seems like every time we get close, it just, you know, get hammered back down. But you know, the RedHawks, you know, they just gotta keep pushing. Just gotta keep pushing. I truly believe that the RedHawks can win this game. I fully believe it. But we just need to stop making errors and, you know, stop letting balls go right past our basemen and not catching routine pop-ups. As long as the RedHawks can walk in here, I'm very confident that this game is still winnable. I mean, we're only about halfway through. We're in the now bottom of the fifth, and it's only 12-7. We're only down 5. Now, in baseball, 5 is a lot. 5 scores is a lot in baseball. A lot of games don't even get the 5 scores total. But, you know, I really believe that, you know, this RedHawks batting can just catch fire and bring us back into this one. Currently warming up for pitcher of Butler is number 21, Colin Daly. This man has a 36 on the dot ERA for the season. Hopefully we can make this man's ERA 50. That would be nice. Again, I'm not a statistical mastermind. I'm really not sure how many runs we need to get to make his ERA from 36 to 50. But, you know, I know it's a lot. I know that it would mean crushing Butler. And I really want to crush these Bulldogs. Now, coming up to bat is number 23 for Miami, Garrison Barrel. Barrel is not hit yet today.
Number 23, Garrison Barrel.
I haven't pitched him. Oh, he just quick pitched him. The count is 0-1, strike. The second pitch he swings at, that is strike two. This pitcher, Colin Daly, maybe I shouldn't have made fun of his 36 ERA. That is now ball one, count is 1-2. Pitch, a sinker down the middle, and that strikes out the first Miami batter of the inning. Now up in the batting order is number four, Tyler Gordon.
Number four, Tyler Gordon.
Hopefully Tyler can pull this one off and get us some good positioning to work with. First pitch. It is fouled hard left. Almost smacking the guy at the vending and concession stand. Almost decapitating the man selling hot dogs. And the second pitch, that is ball one. Count is currently 1-1. Daly winds up, throws the third pitch, not swung at, ball two. That was far on the top right. I think that was fairly clear that that was not in the strike zone. And that was recognized by number 23, or not number 23, number four, Tyler Gordon. My apologies. The count is now 2-2. Next pitch, man, he is struck out by Colin Daly. He has now struck out two consecutive Miami batters, and now coming up is
Ty Bodicich.
Number 24 for Miami, hoping to end this streak of Miami batters struck out. First pitch, ball, far and high to the right. Daly winds up. Another pitch, that is a strike right down the center. I am very surprised that that was not swung at. Next pitch, fouled hard and ground foul to left, almost popping up into the dugout of Miami. Count is 1-2 with two outs with Miami RedHawks. Miami grounds down. He throws it to first, but he is safe. He isn't safe? You look safe. The Bulldogs were trying to make their way off the field. The umps are having a meeting in the center. That looked clearly safe. Maybe I am blind. I thought that the runner had gotten to the first base before the ball made it there, but still. The umps are going over to Miami's dugout right now. they're still standing on the first base, and Butler's players are all bunched up on the infield over by first base. Personally, I could swear that he was safe. And, I mean, if I was called out, I'd be pretty confused. But, again, maybe I'm just a delusional RedHawks fan. I mean, you always bias the team that you're rooting for. Every call. We'll be right back as soon as the action continues and we figure out what the umps are conversating about. Now, seemed that they called him out right there. Miami's defense is now getting on the field with the pitcher Ryan Zimmer, now warming up on the field. I will say it wasn't quite close call on that one, but still, I could swear that the runner got there just slightly before. But it's probably the Miami RedHawks fan delusion right there, which I will probably admit. They might be switching up the catcher situation. Oh, yep. Seems that they're now switching the catcher out. Oh, it seems that the catcher that was in there said he got switched out. It seems like he was just kind of placeholding what the catcher was doing or something. Well, we are now heading into the top of the sixth inning. Coming up to bat for the Bulldogs is number 15,
Tegan Connors.
And Zimmer is looking to get him out quickly here. Just a score update. It is currently 12-7, but we're winning. And that first pitch is a ball. Count is 1-0. The second pitch by Zimmer. Swung on. Swing and a miss. Strike one. Zimmer's third pitch. He's winding up. Throws a 91 mile per hour heater right down the middle, but it is too low to be called a strike. Then it throws another fastball, but it was just outside the box. That is ball three. The count is 3-1. It's a 92 mile per hour ball right there. Sinner's next pitch. He winds up, throws it, and walks the batter. That was ball four. Butler now has Keegan Connors on first base. And now coming up to bat is number three, AJ. Sorry, they changed their bat order. I don't have this guy's name on my roster. Let me see. I'll get his name in a second. AJ Solomon. Oh, he tries to pick off Keegan Connors at first, but he just missed by an inch. 1 millisecond earlier, and he would have gotten him there. He tries to get Keegan Connors again with the pickoff, but he's just not fast enough. Not for Zimmerman, that's wild, because he's out here throwing like 92, 95 like it's nothing. Strike one. 0-1 is the count. He tries to pick him off again, but he is safe. Keegan Connors keeps taking a lot of steps out from that first base. Throws the pitch. Strike two on AJ Solomon. Keeping his eye on the runner on first that keeps trying to steal. He tries to pick him off again. Safe again. He's watching that runner at first like a hawk. I'll tell you. And that wasn't even a pun intended because we're the RedHawks. And the next pitch, that was ball one. Counts 1-2. Zimmer throws next strike three, and the catcher whiffs the throw, just throws it too low to the second baseman. Oh, my bad. My apologies, that was the shortstop. Was not able to get that runner out. Oh, did they get? Not sure. The umps are all talking right now. Actually, it seems that shortstop was fast enough and got the man on second out. Sorry for blaming the catcher right there. There are two outs. Now up is Carter. Is it Carter? Yes, Carter Durai for the Butler Bulldogs. Another pitch fouled back. This is now 0-2. One more strike, and that will be the top of the 6-4. Butler over. Let's bank on Zimmer getting a strike right here. Zimmer threw it. But he was just outside the box. That is ball one. Count is 1-2. Zimmer throws again. It is grounded to the right fielder. He makes it to first, but no farther.
Number 12, Joey Irving.
Two outs, a runner at first. And coming up to the plate is Joey Urban from the Butler Bulldogs. Currently is 1-for-3 in his at-bats and appearances, but see what happens. He fouled right there. First strike. Looks like he fell over onto himself. Slow to get up. Batter's taking a second. Not really 100% sure what just occurred, but he's back. He picked up his bat. I'm just telling him to get in the box. Oh boy. Joey Urban now standing in the box. In his stance. Zimmer throws a heater right down the center, 84 miles per hour. Not his fastest pitch, but accurate. That's strike two. One more strike, and that is the end of Butler's batting for this inning. Grounded to third, and he drops it. What is happening with the Miami RedHawks? He fielded a ball that was grounded straight to the third baseman. And then, like, he has a hole in his glove, it just dropped out of his hand. Right before he could throw it to either first or second to try and get that third out. But wow. It's a rough goings for the Miami RedHawks today, I'll tell you that. Sorry for the singing there. Apologize.
Now pitching for Miami.
RedHawks are switching up the pitching. And now warming up is Carson Byers, a left-handed pitcher. With a 10.57 ERA. I will say, despite being decently frigid and windy, it does look like an aesthetically pleasing day. Nice blue skies, sun shining down on the field. But geez, does that wind cut through you, especially when it's just a bit of chill outside. Even though I am freezing, sitting here right now commentating for you fine people, I will say I'm having fun. Even though I am freezing to death right now. While we wait for this pitcher, number 7, to finish warming up, let's look at the current weather in Oxford. Looks like it is going to get down a bit colder and a little bit heavier. A little cold never bothers anyone. Surely some college baseball players. Now at the plate is Jack Marokinick. On his first pitch, Carson Byers gets a strike. Carson starts to wind up. Byers throws a very low ball. That is not swung. That is ball one. Count is 1-1. Person winds up, pops, batter pops it straight into the air. Hopefully the fielder can get it. And he does, and that is the end of the top of the sixth for Butler. The first inning they've kept them scoreless since the second. I will say this Butler offense has been potent, but they are making some changes. They're switching people out of the order, pushing certain people in. It's an interesting game, to say the least. They are seeming to stick with Colin Daly for the pitcher for Butler, number 21. He's currently at 13 pitches so far. The last two innings so far, Miami has been scoreless, and that's where a hopeful trail became a very big divot between the scores that we got here today. Still, 12-7 is the score. Hopefully, Miami can turn around here and score some in this inning. Now, up is number 11. The home run hitter himself, Zach McDonald. First pitch, strike from Colin Daly. He is winding up, second pitch. That was far outside, that was a ball. Another ball on the third pitch. Haley winds up, throws, whoa, into the left for ball three. Count is 3-1. And throws it again, just right down the center. Daly is pretty dangerous, but I have faith in Zach McDonald. Count is 3-2, count is full. And Donald fouls. McDonald gets walked. Now up to the plate is number 15, Rylan Zaborowski. First pitch, it is called a strike. Second pitch, it looks like it's going far, way out there. And that's a home run for the RedHawks. Two runs. The score is now 12-9. I told you I didn't hear no bell. The RedHawks are back in this, rolling down 3 runs, and it's only the start of the bottom of the 6th with 0 outs. The RedHawks have a chance. I don't know if the Red Hawk is the most appropriate bird for this team, because I think a Phoenix would work better. Because we've been rising. I'd like to apologize. That was really corny. But yeah. Now up is number 31, Ryan Novak. First pitch. Ball. Pitches again. Ball two. The count is 2-0. Third pitch. And strike. Count is now 2-1. Daly starts to wind up. Throws it. Novak leaned into it. But that is ball three. Count's 3-1 now. You remember 3-1 and you're a Cavs fan. You know that's a good combination. Strike two. That is now a full count. Count is 3-2. Novak. Daly winds up and throws a third strike, striking out Ryan Novak. Now up to the plate is number 6, Dylan Baker. There's only one out and no batters on the bases. That is such a clear ball. It was made 2 feet from the box to the left. As ball one on the first pitch of the at-bat. Second pitch. Right down there, that is strike one. Count is now 1-1. Dylan Baker's watching. He fouls off. Going way up and to the right. Over towards the parking lot, towards Farmer and Garden Commons. Count is 1-2. Next pitch. He grounds it straight up the middle of the field. And that will go for a single for Dylan Baker.
Number two,
now at bat, Anthony Zarlingo. He has still yet to get a hit in this game today, but still have faith. Hopefully we can turn things around. Oh, it seems like the catcher and the rest of the Bulldogs, besides the outfielders, are huddling up for a second, doing a mound visit. So our window is training, getting ready, loosening himself up. Get ready for this at bat. Oh, wow. Alan Daly had a pitch count of 31 so far. Get to use the pitch. And then he throws the pitch. That is strike one on the first. With a batter on first, or a runner on first, and only one out for the run. The second pitch. Ball one. Count is tied up, 1-1. Ready for the Bulldogs, winds up, throws a pitch way low. And Dylan Baker steals second off of the catcher's mistake, not being able to just get a hold on that ball. Going right past him, right behind home plate and towards our press booth. There's now a RedHawk on second, and Zarlingo still trying to get his hit. Count is 2-1. And Dylan Baker now steals third after another missed catch by the catcher. It's a rough few minutes for that catcher. But the second one was also a wild pitch. Count is now 3-2. That is ball three. Just happened. Full count. Jeez, the gust of wind. Oh! He barely hits it. And he's safe at first. And we score a run. Scored by Dylan Baker, number six. Zarlingo made it all the way to one on a very shallow, but low pop up that landed just at the feet of the second baseman right there. He tried to dive for it, but he ended up missing it. Seems like the manager went to talk to his team after what had just transpired. Now, they have switched the pitcher and are now warming up a new pitcher. Number 37 for Butler University, Brett Shepard. This guy's ERA on his stat sheet is 4.91. Seems quite good. But I feel like these stats, and especially in college, are not as accurate because there's one, not as many games as MLB, and two, there's just so many guys and that play in a single game in college that I feel like it's not the most accurate statistical reading for a lot of teams and a lot of guys out here. Because we've had guys who were just destroying Miami on pitching for like a while, and they, I mean, the one guy's ERA was like 36. Just wild. Yeah, but now batting is number 8, Justin Gorski, the designated hitter. Hope he sends it flying.
Number 8, Justin Gorski.
Let's see what Brett Shepard, the new pitcher, has got. Brett starts to wind up. Throws the ball. Fouled out. Almost hitting the hot dog guy in the head. That was 0-1. He just got a pitch he likes from his catcher. Shepard winds up. Throws the pitch. He grounds it. And the fumbled double play. They got one out on that. They got Zarlingo out on that at second base. But Gorski was able to make it just in time to first before they were able to pull off the double play on the RedHawks. Now up to bat is number 23, Garrison Barrill. with a Red Hawk at first as well. Two outs. First pitch, ball one. That was a fairly slow pitch, only 69 miles per hour on that one. He tries to pick the runner on first off, but he is too late. Third pitch. Fouled way up and over the dugout of Butler. It is 1-1. Strike two on the next pitch. Two outs, one Red Hawk on first. And pitch. And a stolen second base by Justin Gorski. And ball two. There's a mistake with a semi-wild pitch not being picked up by the catcher right away. Now the pitch. Ball three. Full count, 3-2. Garrison Morrow is looking to get a base. And he is struck out on that. And that is the end of the sixth inning. Score is 12-10, Butler winning. But I will say, this is some of the closest we've been. I think we're down two for a lot of the early innings, but after at least the second, but feels close. Miami is sticking with Carson Byers as their pitcher for the top of the seventh. Miami picked up a pretty good offensive stretch right there, scoring three runs in that bottom of the sixth inning. So hopefully we can just keep that fire going and that train on rolling, and in the victory we go. At bat four, Butler is number one, Ethan Verkrumba. Pitching is still Carson Byers for Miami. Miami throws the pitch. He tried to bunt and bounce. You see off of his head. Butler's dugout does not seem too thrilled with that. It's about the fourth Butler player been hit by a pitch today in this game. Now, up at the plate is number six, Cade Lewis. He is 1-for-4 from the plate in today's game. Person throws the pitch. It is fouled off to the left into the home plate fence. Or netting. May I say.
second pitch. It is hit up and straight.
A runner advances to first. He runs. The other runner goes all the way to third on that. These Miami RedHawks really need to just stop letting up big plays like that.
Number seven, Billy Wirtz.
There's now a runner at first, a runner at third, and there are zero outs for Butler. Now, at the plate is number seven, Billy Wirtz. It's hit straight up, straight to the pitcher. They throw it to first, get one out, but there is a run scored by Butler. 13-10, with now only a runner at second. Now coming up to the plate is number 13, Xavier Carter. Xavier's 2-for-4 so far in this game. Let's hope that goes to 2-5. Or 2-for-5. The first pitch, it is a ball, not swung. Counts 1-0. Second pitch, a ball hit far in left foul territory. Did he get it? He just ran into a wall. Well, the player dove into the foul wall, but it was still foul. Good hustle, though. Bye. Anthony Zarlingo in the outfield. Our pitch, the count is 2-1. Two balls, one strike. And only one out for Butler with a man on second base. Foul territory again. Count is now 2-2. And that is a strikeout. Two outs for Butler now. Miami looking to get a third batter out. Again, there's a runner on second. And now in the game and at the bat is number 11, Drew Charney. Here's the pitch. There's ball one. Just a bit outside to the left. By just a bit, I mean a decent bit, but not too much. Second pitch, right down the center and swung on, strike one. That was a good ball. Byers winds up, throws another. Take a strike. I thought he swung. That is now ball two. The count is 2-1. Hey, another ball. Ball three. The count is 3-1. Just like the lead the Warriors blew in 2016. Anyway, Drew Charney looking. Alright, big hit, and that is going foul. Count is now 3-2. Fires warms up, throws, and strikes out another batter. That's the end of the top of the seventh.
For Butler.
For Butler, the top of the seventh, one run on one hit. All right, fans, you know what that brings up. Time to stretch a little bit. Do some jumping jack. Get some of the cold air in your lungs. Sing a little Take Me Out to the Ball Game.
Yeah. I don't know if they're playing Take Me Out to the Ball Game, I'll be honest. It's just silence in the ballpark.
Take me out to the ball game. Take me out to the crowd. Buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jacks. I don't care if we ever get back to this room full of RedHawks. If they don't win, it's a shame. Cause it's one, two, three
strikes here out at the old ball game.
Now let's get some RedHawks.
Someone sing on RedHawk Radio, but I'm an innovator. Still warming up is the pitcher previously using last inning. Pitcher number 37, Brett Shepard. Excuse me, Sherrard thing. I will say this covering, does sure make a lot of noise. And now, up at bat is number 4, Tyler Gordon for the Miami RedHawks. Quick pitch, grounded far into left field. He looks like he is settling for a single. Stops at first. Now, up to bat is number 24, Ty Batusic.
Number 24, Ty Batusic.
About. I don't feel comfortable saying that name. How the announcer said it. Anyway, Brett Sherrard now winding up. Throws the pitch. Ball one. Pitch is looking over at Gordon. Trying to pick him off, but he, again, is too slow. Look, everybody's trying to pick off someone at first base this game, but it's just not getting it. Anyway, pitcher winds up, throws, foul ball high into the netting of home plate. Brett Sherrard getting ready. Watching Gordon over on first. Pitches. Strike two. Count is 1-2. Tucic is ready. Tries to pick off Gordon again, but again, it's too late. He is safe. Shard winds up, throws the fastball right down the center. But again, it was too low. Ball two. Count is now 2-2. Next pitch. And, oh my, he hit it right into the first baseman, which it bounced off his glove, and then he dove for it after it ricocheted up in the air, and then he caught it. Gordon stays still at first base, but Ty Batusic is out. And now coming up, batting at the plate, is number 11, Zach McDonald, the home run hitter from earlier. He tries to pick off Gordon again. This pitcher does not like him taking a few steps away from that plate. And Tyler Gordon steals second after a wild pitch leaves the ball far and behind home plate and past the catcher. One out and a Red Hawk at second base. Count is now 1-1 after that strike. Schrard is getting ready to pitch again. Watching Gordon over at second. Pitches way out. Ball two. Next pitch, strike two. 82 mile per hour changeup to the left. Howard is trying to cook up another pitch. Throws very low, ball three. Full count, 3-2. Howard still looking back over at Gordon and trying to ensure he didn't steal. And threaten to pick off. Throws pitch. And strikes out Zach McDonald. Two outs. And one Red Hawk on second base. Now entering the game is number 15, Rylan Zabarowski. Rylan's looking to hit big right now. Hopefully get his team back in the running. And my big, he hit it just straight up in there. Hopefully one of them drops it. But that is the third out and the end of the seventh inning. After catching the pop-up deep into center field by Rylan Zabarowski.
For Miami, at the bottom of the seventh, the runs on one hit.
And the pitch and hit to deep center field, and it is caught immediately. One out.
And now coming up to plate is number four, Carter Durie. Number seven, Carson Byers is still pitching for Miami. Throws the first pitch. Strike one. Right down the middle. Byers winds up, throws another pitch, very low and not swinging. That is ball one. There's the pitch. Hit but foul. That is count towards the strike. Count is now 1-2. One out for Butler, and no men anywhere on base. And hit far into left field. That is a single for Carter Durie. Now coming up to the plate for Butler is number 12. Joey Urban.
Number 12, Joey Urban.
They have three at first. One out. Fires looks to get this batter out quickly. Strike one, right in center, right in the box. Tries to pick off the runner at first, but it's too late. Fires, throws another strike right down the center to Joey Urban and the box. One more strike and he is out. Safe. Three. Runs and steals second during the pitch, which was a ball. Myers watching closely and striking out Joey Urban. That is two outs for Butler now, and now approaching the box is Jack Mrocknick. Three is sitting there on second with Carson Byers watching him closely. As the batter is talking to his third base coach. Hitting it high, but foul. What? Count is 0-1. Two outs and a runner at second. His pitch. That's what I said. But deep. Does the center fielder have it? He catches it, and that's the end of the top of the eighth.
quarterback? And we are back. Butler now has a different pitcher on the mound. Number 24, Cole Graverson. They are warming him up at the moment. And now up at bat is Miami's number 31, Ryan Novak. Still has yet to get a hit this game.
Off for the
Redhawks. First pitch throws a fastball right down the center for a strike. 80 miles per hour fastball. Now throws another fastball right down the center for a strike. Twice in a row. Now the pitcher throws one very low. Almost in the dirt. Here we see the pitcher throwing to the bottom right. That is ball two. Count is now 2-2. That is ball number three right there. Full count, 3-2. Harrison winds up, throws a pitch down and to the right. Walks the batter. It's ball four. Now up is number six, Dylan Baker for Miami.
Number six, Dylan Baker.
Dylan Baker hits it deep, but is it deep enough? It is not as caught by the left outfielder. No maker is out, and that is the first out for Miami in the inning. Now up is number two, up at the plate, Anthony Zarlingo for the Redhawks. Here's the pitch, fastball down the center, that is a strike. Zarlingo's ready, getting in his hitting formation. Pearson throws up, throws a very, very low pitch. That's ball one. Miami's got a runner on first. He's peeking him. Ball two. That almost hit. Zerlingo in the chest. Thankful he dodged. Here's the pitch. Hit. Grounded right in the second. And the double play to the end. The inning for Butler. Getting Dylan Baker out at second and Zerlingo out at first. Hit straight up the middle, right over the mound and right to that second baseman, who then made the double play, throwing it to the first baseman. Cade Lewis, who proceeded to get to the plate before our own Anthony Zerlingo. Now Miami's headed back out to the field with Carson Byers warming up with a few pitches. I'll tell you, Miami fans, while it is unlikely with a score like this so late in the game, I've seen crazier. We're currently down 3. Total score is 13-10 with the Butler University Bulldogs winning by 3. As long as we can play some solid defense, get some solid fielding, good pitching in, get them out quickly, and then just score 4 runs, we'll win. I know it's not that simple, but make note. And it is quite cold. I kind of want to go home. Up at the plate is number 1, Ethan Verkrumba. First pitch, right down the center. That is a strike. Byers starting to wind up. There's the pitch. Whoa. Ball one. Throws a strike ball right down the center. It's 76 miles per hour. Count is 1-2. Let's get him stroking out right now. And that is strike 3. He's out. Next coming up to the plate is number 26. Evan Parks. A new member of the lineup at the moment. First pitch. It is a strike. Carson is now thrown 2 consecutive strikes. Let's try for a third. Ball. Threw it low towards the ground of his catcher's mitt. Counts 1-1 with 1 out and nobody on bases. Person winds up. Fouled back. Count is now 1-2. Is getting ready. Winds up. Throws. And strikes. A second batter out in a row. That's 2 outs for Butler. Miami might do it. They can help. The dream is still alive. Now, up at the plate for Butler is number 7, Billy Wirtz. First pitch is a ball, going all the way to the left. Second pitch, he gets him with an 89 mile per hour strike ball. It was just outside the box, but he swung at it. Goes in. He fouls off up high and to the right. Almost over the dugout of the Butler Bulldogs. Billy Wirtz stiff back at the plate in his stance. Byers gets ready. Winds up. Throws a pitch. Wild pitch over his catcher's head. Not caught. Good thing nobody's on the bases. That is faulted. So that counts 2-2. There's two outs. Nobody on bases for Butler. There's ball 3. Full count, 3-2. Now up to the plate is number 13, Xavier Carter of Butler. Butler has a man on first who walked. And he just, Carter hits a far bar into deep right field. And Wirtz goes all the way home. Oh no, they got him out. I retract my statement. They were able to get him out before he touched home plate. The score is 13-10. The umpires are doing replay at this very moment. Miami thought that they had for sure gotten him out, so, I mean, their entire team was already walking back off the field after that, so, makes you wonder. Butler's players are going out on the field, so I guess it was ruled out, yep. Butler's fielders and basemen are all coming out on the field. Well, now it is the bottom of the ninth. It comes down to this. Still at pitcher is Cole Graverson for Butler. And they're still all warming up. And headed to bat is number 10 from Miami. just waiting for that pitcher to get done warming up. Number 10, Trey Kills, is now at bat for the RedHawks. Can the RedHawks come back from down 3 with only this inning to play? Or can they tie it and go to extra innings? Which I would like as a fan, but it is also very cold out here. But I'm rooting for the RedHawks anyway. Rain or shine. Cold or hot. Trey Kills takes the pitch. First pitch is a strike after he swung on it. That was pretty deep out of the box. Very low pitch on that one. Ball. 75 mile per hour. Very close to the ground. Here's the pitch. Almost hitting Trey Kills in the middle of the shin with that one. It was so far right. Almost hit the batter. Basically threw that into the dirt of the box. Strike two. The count is now 2-2. After he swung at another. What it seemed to be a ball. Ball three. But he's dug out rallying their teammate. Gotta hit big or get a walk. He hit it deep. But is it deep enough? And it is caught by the center fielder of Butler. That is Miami's first out. Now,
coming
up to plate, number nine, Blake Gazeo. One out, no one on bases. Pitcher throws a ball first. Pitch. There's a wild pitch that goes right behind the catcher. Harrison looking. Winds up. Throws the pitch. Whoa. Ball two. No swing on that. Ball three. Throws it into the line of paint. The batter's box is part of. Harrison throws a. Not a strike, that is a walk. At first I thought that was in a strike zone, but I guess it was not. Now, up for Miami is number. Miami at bat is number 29. It was David Novak. First pitch, a strike. Runner at first. Second pitch, strike two. With one out. A runner at first. And two strikes on the board. No balls. And strike three. Two outs. Only a runner at first. It's looking grim for the RedHawks.
Number 24, Ty Bonsai.
up at the plate. Number 24, Ty Batush. First pitch, strike. Now the pitcher, Cole Gaverson, looking over, maybe think about picking off. Bike was out. But throws a ball. Count is 1-1. Still watching the runner at first base. Throws the pitch. Ball two. Count is 2-1. Two outs in the game, one more out, and that will be the end of it. Score is 13-10 with Butler edging Miami out. The strike two. Sadly, it looks one more strike will be the end of the RedHawks' hopes tonight. Here's the pitch. Ball three. Full count, 3-2. With a runner still at first. Grounder. And that is game. Butler gets Ty Batush out at the first base after throwing the ball all the way from center field. Well, this is a very, very unfavorable outcome, but I will say it was a very entertaining and engaging game. A lot of action, a lot of scoring, a lot of back and forth. Wish Miami would have won, but you know. So overall, very enjoyable game. You know, first our boys struggled a bit, you know, but.